Hey there, welcome to Life Noggin. About 71% of the Earth's surface is covered in water, yet a massive amount of the ocean still remains a mystery to scientists. But the parts that have been studied are incredibly fascinating. Scientists have found an illusion of an underwater waterfall, an underwater Grand Canyon, and even a lost Egyptian city, which totally sounds made up, but I promise I'm not lying to you. Another thing that scientists have found are a bunch of terrifying creatures living in the ocean that are probably better left unseen. But we're gonna show you them anyway. First up, we have everybody's favorite, the giant squid. Well, everyone's favorite except for Herman Melville, who described the squid's arms as curling and twisting like a nest of anacondas in his novel Moby Dick. These are massive, terrifying creatures with eyes the size of dinner plates and lengths greater than a school bus. And when it's time for them to eat, they capture their prey with their two long feeding tentacles, bringing it in towards their beak, which cuts the prey into pieces. And then their tongue-like radula, which is covered in small teeth, cuts and shreds the prey even further before being swallowed by the giant squid. Next up is a friendlier giant called the giant isopod, which looks like a real-life version of Kabuto from Pokemon. These are crustaceans and are related to other animals like shrimp and crabs. They can get to be over 2 feet in length, which scientists think is an adaptation to help them survive in the high pressures of the deep ocean. They are bottom dwellers, living up to 2,100 meters deep and usually eat the dead carcasses they find on the ocean floor. That sounds appetizing. Next, we have a creature with a funny name. Zombie worms. What's weird about these worms is they are able to feed off the bones of dead fish and whales all without having a mouth, stomach, or any way to drill inside the bones. Instead, they secrete an acid that dissolves the bone, allowing the zombie worms to access the protein and fat inside. And from there, bacteria living inside the worm digest the macronutrients. And fun fact, another thing living inside these worms are the microscopic males, which means that all the zombie worms feeding on the bones are the females of the species. Lastly, we have the goblin shark, who is just as scary looking as its name implies. The beast can get longer than 3 meters and find their prey by detecting the electric fields generated by other animals. They usually eat creatures like crabs and squid and do so by having their jaw protrude from their face, capturing their prey. Yeah. It's super freaky to watch, but also kinda cool. It's times like these that I am thankful I live on land. Wait. Oh no, please, animator, don't do this to me. Help! Oh, okay, we're back. So what is your favorite deep sea creature? Did I miss any of the good ones? Let me know in the comment section below. I want to give a special shout out to the Vlogbrothers for making this video possible. If you don't already watch John and Hank, I highly recommend it. They make some of the best, most thought-provoking videos on YouTube. Thanks for being awesome, guys. As always, I'm Blacko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.